Yo, what's good, YouTube? This is Jay from TNJ. And make sure you hit that like button. We are going up against Georgia State this week. And they are 1-4, struggling this year. But remember, they did a number on us last year. They beat us. So we're looking for revenge here. You see Appalachian State is already, look at them. They're at 88 overall, 90 offense, 87 defense. So whenever we go against them, it's going to be tough. Let's just look at our remaining schedule here as we do go against them next week. So that's going to be a really, really tough game. And then towards the end of the year, we do play a tough Arizona State team on the road. So looking at the other side of the division here, the other side of the conference, Louisiana is on top, 2-1 in conference, Arkansas State. It's kind of a close race on both sides of the conference here. So let's just check out Georgia State really quickly. So we're going on the road, and the road games are always tough no matter who you're playing, especially with these sliders and the team that we have. But looking at them, they are number 125 in points per game. We got to stop them. That means they have a bad offense. They can't really pass, can't really run. You see they're ranked pretty low. And then and as far as defense goes, they're actually ranked in the middle of the country, 94 in rush defense. Maybe we can run the ball a little bit on them. Maybe they don't have such a great front. But we'll have to see because you never know. I mean, a lot of these games, you just never know. Let's just look at the scores of the games that they're losing. So they're not getting blown out at all. Let's just look at their schedule. Let's go back over to it. But I mean, they're just losing games. I mean, they're not really getting destroyed. Two touchdowns, it looks like. They lost to Oregon by three touchdowns, but they even lost to FCS actually. So that's pretty embarrassing. They lost to FCS. So maybe we might get to run away from this one, but we never want to go into a game too confident, but let's get this one done. So we are on the road, and one thing I like about playing Georgia State at the Georgia Dome is that you don't have to worry about the weather. No bad weather, no wind is a factor. And here we go. We're underway, and Georgia State is going to start with the ball. So here they go on offense as starting it out, Cameron Knight with the 12-yard reception. So here is Winchester under center here, rolling out to the right, and he's picking up 8 yards. Aaron Winchester, he's a scrambling quarterback. He can also throw the ball, but his arm is definitely just not his strong suit, as you're going to see a lot of play action, a lot of runs, and they're not a hurry-up team. They don't run a lot of hurry-up, so they're going to be handing it off to who else? Trey Barnett, and he's a pretty good running back, number 5 there. As you can see, he's their best player on offense, as here he is once again getting a couple of yards. So now here's Winchester giving the ball out to Barnett, and it's maneuvering his way inside the 5-yard line and getting into the end zone. Look at the way he just maneuvered around the defense that time, and he beats the rest of our squad to the end zone. So that seemed a little too easy. As Georgia State goes down the field and scores the first points of the game. But here we are, Kashawn Curtin had a 50% completion percentage last game, and he's looking to continue. He's actually been having a pretty good year throwing the ball. So here he is on the 3rd and 7, throwing the ball deep, but this one is going to be picked off by Lazarus. He didn't have enough on that throw, and Jack Kleck was downfield, but he just didn't have enough on it, and the safety comes over Lazarus, and he makes the interception. So that's the first turnover already on the first drive. So here's Georgia State back on offense, picking up a block from the receiver is Gentry, and he's going to skip down the sideline. And on the first play of the next drive, Aaron Winchester finds his receiver open, and that's another touchdown, 14-0. And it's only been 2 minutes into this game. So here is Sam Forbes getting the end around, and he's getting 28 yards, his longest run of his career so far as a senior. So we continue this drive, giving the ball off to Tyron Summers for 10 yards, and on a 1st and 10, throwing the ball across the middle of that Sam Forbes, getting the pass one more time for 12 yards as he moves the ball inside the 10-yard line. So now on a 2nd and goal, here's Curtin from the shotgun. Nobody to throw it to, and he's taken the sack there that time by Clifford Amazing, and that's going to be a 3rd and goal at the 15-yard line. As here on a play action, curtain's going down. No time to throw that ball. And we do have to settle for the field goal. So now here comes Trey Barnett back out onto the field. 12 yards on that carry. So here's Winchester under center giving the ball to Barnett one more time. And look at this hole to the outside. And nobody's there on the outside contain. And he gets another big first down. So now here's Winchester under center here on the first and 10. But this time he's going to get tackled and sacked by Chris Thornton. Nice tackle that time. And he wraps him up before he can get out of the pocket. So now on a third and 13, giving the ball off to Jones up the middle. And Tamir Jones almost gets a first down. But that's going to be a fourth and inches as they do kick the long field goal. And Georgia State scores on their first three drives and makes it 17-3. So here towards the end of the first quarter, here's Tyron Summers getting going on the ground for a nice 9-yard gain. So we do end up getting the first down. And here's Kashawn Curtin rolling up the middle. And he's picking up another gain of 9. So now on a second and 1, here's Tyron Summers getting the handoff up the middle. And he's getting a few yards, just enough for the first down. So here to start the second quarter, here's Kashawn Curtin rolling out to the right, throwing across the middle. And Sam Forbes seems like he's been the only one who's made any catches so far. And he picks up another first down. So now on a second and 13, here is Curtin rolling out to the right and diving for an 11-yard gain. And that those extra yards definitely help us there as we run the ball here on a third and 1 and pick up just 3. But that's enough for the first down. So now on a first and 10, here is Summers getting the handoff one more time and picking up 10 yards on that carry. So now inside the 20-yard line, here is Curtin finding another running lane. And look at this. We are moving the ball on the ground on this drive. And we already said that was our identity going forward. And we do get in for the touchdown. That's Tyron Summers, the junior, as he continues a great season as he's going to, you know, run away with the best season as a running back so far in this dynasty as he continues to pile on the yards and touchdowns. So now down by 7. Can we stop Georgia State here on defense? And not with Trey Barnett getting carries like that. That one goes for 9 yards. So now here's Trey Barnett getting the handoff to the outside, but only picking up 3. But that's enough for the first down. So now they're past the 50-yard line. Here's Barnett on the delay handoff, the draw. And he's getting to the right side and picking up another big gain. So we said before the game that this might be a little easier on defense, but not so fast. Here is Orlando Norman coming up with the interception after switching sides. Remember, he played on the right side of the field the whole year last year. And he comes up with another interception. He's been hot this year, as I like what I see from him. And he comes up with a crucial interception. So now we have a chance to tie this game up. Driving the ball down the field, but Kashawn Curtin gets hit on the throw and he fumbles it away. And look at number 51. He comes in unblocked. And that's going to be a strip sack, as now Georgia State takes over inside the 20-yard line as they try to run the ball to the outside. And Trey Barnett gets another 15 yards and continues his drive. But now on a first and goal, here's Winchester trying to roll out. Gets almost tripped up, but Aaron Winchester gets in for the touchdown. You know he's not much of a thrower, but he gets in for the scramble. So now here we go. 3 minutes left in this half, down 2 scores. And this is looking a lot like last week with a lot of points given up. But here is Tyron Summers getting going on the ground here. Got to keep it balanced as he's at 68 yards in this game. So now on a first and 10, here he is getting the ball one more time and running the ball up the middle. And that's going to be a nice carry. So we eventually do get a first down as here is Curtin from the shotgun throwing the ball to Sam Forbes once again. And Sam Forbes is just getting open in this first half as he moves the chain. So now under a minute left in this game here on a third and 18 after losing a couple yards on a sack. Here's Curtin throwing to the right side and that's going to be caught in the end zone by Tyron Summers. Look at this ball. It gets tipped around but somehow bounces off a defender off the knee of Tyron Summers, and Tyron Summers gets under it. Look at it. Hits a knee, and Tyron Summers catches it for the touchdown. So some luck there, and sometimes it's needed as we're now down by 7 points, but under a minute left, three timeouts. Georgia State has enough time to drive down the field, and they put together after a nice return that time. Gets inside the 20-yard line already after two plays, but here is Winchester picking up 8 yards on that scramble, so we got to keep him out of the end zone here. So now 20 seconds left. Here's Winchester rolling out to the right, and they do have one timeout left, and they are going to actually run this clock down and call the timeout and kick the field goal going into half up 27-17. So now to start this second half, we do start out with the ball, so advantage them because they did end up going into half with a 2-score lead, but we can make up. I believe in this offense. We have a pretty solid offense. If we continue to run the ball well, we can do some good things. So here's Garrison Burnett, the actual gadget guy on our team. And remember, he has some throwing skills. We might even try to use him at quarterback in the future. So now here is Kershawn Curtin throwing out to the right side, and Sam Forbes having a big game so far. Has had a few big catches, that one long reverse, and he's over 100 yards, all-purpose yards already. But here on a play action, look who's open. That's Byron Dunlap, the redshirt freshman. Remember when we recruited him during the first season, we said he'd be a blocking tight end, but that time he gets in for his first receiving touchdown of the season as we are now down by 3 points. And here's Trey Barnett back out on offense trying to get going. Can't get a lot on that one. But on a 3rd and 5, here is Hart getting open down the sideline. We send the blitz, but Winchester does find Penny Hart down the sideline for that nice pitch and catch. So now they're past the 35-yard line. And here's Jonathan Effetti getting the 2-yard reception that time, tackled by Orlando Norman. So on a 2nd and 8, here is Winchester throwing out to the flat, and Devin Gentry gets 7 yards. So they do eventually pick up the first down here with 3 minutes left in this third quarter, as here's Winchester under center, giving the ball off to Barnett. And this time we are tackling him in the backfield that time, led by a couple of Coastal defenders. And on a 3rd and 7, throwing the screen pass to the right side. That one's Chris Thornton on the tackle. He's all over the field having a good year. And we do get them to settle for the field goal as they now take the 6-point lead. But here is Kershawn Curtin throwing out to Mike Harrison. And Mike Harrison was wide open on that, but that's overthrown. But on a 3rd and 10, here he is finding Sam Forbes on the outside. And once again, Sam Forbes, 22 yards on that one, picks up the first down. So now on a 1st and 10, here is Tyron Summers getting the handoff to the left side, and he's picking up 7 yards. So now here is Tyron Summers about to get the ball one more time, and we just got to ride the horse, and he's bringing us inside the 30-yard line. And here he is on a 1st and 10. We run a hurry up, throwing the screen pass to him. The defense is not expecting that, and look at Tyron Summers breaking to the outside and picking up a 23-yard gain. So now we give Jimbo Brown the ball, giving Tyron Summers a little break as Jimbo gets back-to-back carries and finishes off this drive. 1 yard run up the middle, and now we take the lead going into the fourth quarter, as here is Barnett getting the ball, starting this next drive there for 6 yards. So now under center, here's Winchester on the draw play, giving it off to Barnett. And look who's there, is Frederick Billups. And remember, he plays defensive end in some packages. He gets his first tackle, a big one on that one. So now on a 3rd and 5, here is Ruff getting the tackle up the middle. So the two big tackles to get them to punt for the first time in this game, as now we have to just milk this clock and move the ball. But on a 3rd and 7, here is Angel Gonzalez getting open. And you haven't heard his name much lately, but he gets in for a nice clutch catch here in the fourth quarter. So now on a 2nd and 6, you run him in motion, but that time it's going to be a strip sack. And Kashawn Curtin fumbles that one. And look at 52 just puts on the swim move on our defense, on our left guard that time, and strips Curtin for his second fumble of the game. So now, can we stop Winchester? He set up a pretty good field position, as here he is scrambling there for 6 yards. And now on the next play, we do send a blitz on a second and four, and Brandon Jones gets in for the sack, and we do have to play some defense here on a third and nine. We send another blitz, and look who's there for the interception. That's Cedric Granger, the junior captain. And Cedric Granger has actually been quietly having a good year. I mean, if you look at his stats, they're not overly inflated with a lot of tackles, but he's just doing everything right, filling gaps, playing good defense, and that shows right there on the interception. So now, here we are, 3.5 minutes left in this half. Can we run this ball effectively while milking this clock? So here's Jimbo Brown. We got to give him the ball because he's got some power moving the sticks on that run. And he's getting close to the 50-yard line on that one. So now here, Tyron Summers back in the game. 2 minutes, 15 seconds left in the game. He's picking up 9 yards on that carry. And another first down. So they are down to one timeout here. First and 10. And look at Tyron Summers finding another big hole. 18 yards as they use their final timeout. All we need is one more first down, and we got this. So on a second and four, here is Jimbo Brown. He picks up 10, and that's going to do it here in this game as we hold on. Don't allow any points in the fourth quarter, and we hold on to win this game 31-30 as Tyron Summers has a big game, 154 yards on the ground. We gave it to him 27 times. We didn't throw the ball that much, but Jimbo Brown got a lot of carries as well, 9 carries for 50 yards, and this was just an all-around good win because I liked what I saw from my defense in the second half. We didn't give up many points in the second half. First half, we struggled quite a bit, and I credit that to Georgia State. I mean, they had a good game plan coming at us with a lot of run-heavy plays, and I got to say, I mean, that running back was something special. He did his thing, but, I mean, our defense showed up in the second half, like I said, and we didn't get many sacks because they didn't throw the ball too much, but we held their passing game, I think, in check for the most part. And what a game by Cedric Granger. I liked a lot what I saw from guys on the back end, like Alan King. He had a good game. Didn't see his name much in the box score, but he was making plays. So I like what I saw from both sides of the ball. 31 points is definitely enough to win the game, but 30 points is a little too much to give up. So we got to make some adjustments in the first half, but it's a good win. I mean, this was versus a 1-4 team, but we got the win. So hit subscribe, hit that like button. We're coming back for the next episode. Remember, we're playing Appalachian State. If we win that game, that's a swing game definitely on our side of the conference. So you don't want to miss that one. So stay tuned. Let's get it. Let's go.